sounds like you're making a desperate prayer. You might want to make one while you're there. Then I'm going to need to stick up your index fingers, your pointer fingers, holding, ask you to open up the fingers about an inch, and then I'll ask you to focus on the gap in between nowhere else. I'll then click my fingers, and I want you to allow your fingers to come together like two powerful magnets. Watch it, don't fright it. When your fingers touch, I'm just going to simply ask that you close your eyes. Is that good?
That was perfect.
Is it okay if I touch your shoulders from time to time? Lovely. Thumbs up for me. Drop your hands, give it like you're trying to start a fight. Let that hypnosis go up your fingertips, up your elbow, up all the way to your shoulder. Interlock your fingers. Nice and tight. And try and crush a piece of coal. That's it. Good. Bend your elbows. Flex the biceps. Stick up your index fingers. Keep them together. This moment forward, only look at your index fingers as I touch you on your right shoulder. Don't look anywhere else. Because in a moment, I'm going to ask you to open them an inch. I'll then click my fingers and I want to allow your fingers to come together like two powerful magnets. Watch it, don't fight it. When your fingers touch, just allow your eyes to close. One, two, three, fingers open. Look at the gap there. Allow those fingers to come together. That's right, like two powerful magnets all by themselves at the center of non-volition. Allow your eyelids to close right now. You're safe and you're secure as your eyelids flutter. Very, very good. What I want you to do now, Athena, is I want you to see the face of the people or person you love most in the world. See their face, feel that love. That's right. And as you see their face and as you feel that love, you feel that growing strength inside of you. And now as you see their face and you feel the love, allow your fingers, fingertips and hands to become glued, stuck, bolted together. Glued, stuck, bolted together. And as you see their face and you feel their love, and you know that you've stuck your fingers together by yourself, just allow your arms to stay, hands to stay stuck, just raise them up in the air, just above your head. Feel that feeling. Now your hands and arms just to raise up in the air. That's right. And as your hands raise up in the air right now, as you see their face and you feel those love, those fingers, those hands become twice as stuck. Now glued, bolted, sellotape, super glued together as tight as you can. As you feel that love and you see their faces, when you know that you've stuck your fingers together, how can you possibly do it? When you know that you've done that through the power of your mind, imagination, try and fail to open up your fingers, find they become more stuck, your hands become more stuck as you see their face and you feel their love. You give it a good old try and fail as your fingers stay stuck and your hands stay stuck when you see their face. It's kind of a weird feeling, isn't it? You're trying, aren't you? And the harder you try, the more stuck they become. But it feels lovely. And what you'll notice now is now your eyelids stay closed, you can allow your hands to come down. Allow your hands to come down. I want to take that same stuck feeling from your fingertips and now put it into your eyelids. That's right. So now allow your eyelids to become stuck, glued, bolted together. It feels lovely, if not a bit weird, and a bit strange at the same time. When you know you've stuck your eyes and eyelids together, and it's stuck, it feels nice, it feels pleasant, but a bit weird. Try and open your eyelids, find they become even more stuck, because you give them a good old try. That's right. And I've got you, I'm just going to twist you a little bit, but I've got your balance tool. And as you try and open your eyelids, find they become more stuck. Your eyelids may go up and down a little bit, that's right, but they stay stuck. And here's the weird thing, Athena. In a moment, I'm going to touch you very softly on your forehead. As I do, your fingers will open, your eyelids will open, you will feel amazing, ready for your next suggestion. One, two, three. Eyelids open. Give her a round of applause. What did that feel like?
Different.
Is it kind of like a bit of a head rush?
I feel more head rush when I smoke cigarettes.
Fair enough.
But it's just different. I've never really experienced something like that before. It's a different
spice. But a good feeling.
Yeah, it's good.
You ready to go down the rabbit hole a little bit deeper?
Yeah.
All right. If I were to give you an amazing suggestion that I was going to tattoo on your brain today, something that's going to stay with you forever, it's going to make you even better. Love life more, maybe be more healthy, drink more. I don't know, but something really cool that's going to empower you to be an even better woman. What suggestions can I give you inside your head? So when you walk away today, you walk away with an amazing gift. Well, I'm a hypnotist, not a psychic, so there's no way. Psychic's over there.
Fair enough. Knowing that no matter what I'm struggling with, that my kids ultimately
can I paraphrase it and say, as long as your kids know that you love them, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Is that cool?
That's right.
You just keep focusing on that here. That's right. Right there. Sleep. Yeah, deeper and deeper. That's right. You Hold your body up perfectly. Allow your eyes to adjust. 1, 2, 3 eyes open. So how did that feel? That's kind of a little bit strange, or are you into strange stuff?
I'm pretty into strange stuff.
You guys, look, I like you guys. I like people that look like they're into strange stuff. I'm into strange stuff as well. Sleep. In a moment, not just yet, but in a moment, I'll count from 1 to 3. When my count reaches 3, the weirdest thing in the world is going to happen. Your feet are going to be stuck to the ground. Your feet will be stuck to the ground with super glue, with glue, and it will feel weird.
Focus on a bit of your foot right now. Focus on the top of your foot right now. Allow that foot to become glued. Keep your focus right here. You'll say, allow your foot to become glued, to become stuck, to become bolted to the ground right there. Lock, glued, stuck, bolted to the ground right there. Allowing that foot to sink into the ground, glue into the ground, feeling really good, feeling really safe. And when you know that you've stuck your foot to the ground, that you've glued that foot to the ground with your imagination, focus, and intelligence, I can't do this for you, only you can do it. That same glue that's on your eyelids, the same glue that's on your fingertips now can be in that foot. When you know that you've stuck your foot to the ground, try and move it, find it becomes even more stuck down like that. It's kind of weird, isn't it? It's weird, isn't it? Notice what happened now. It feels even heavier now, that's right. And now, as I touch you on your forehead, just allow your eyes to close. You're nice and safe, you're nice and secure, you can keep your balance your whole time. In a moment, not just yet, but in a moment, I'll count from 1 to 5. When my count reaches 5, you're gonna know that you're a great mother. You're gonna know that, man, what you do in your life, your kids are gonna read that you're a great mother. Whether you're dealing with your own stuff, as we do as human beings, as parents in life, it doesn't matter. You always deal with your stuff, but you'll be the best mother imaginable, because you already are. And your kids don't just pick up on words, but they pick up on body language and vibes. Well, and you know that as long as you keep working on yourself, loving yourself, and doing good work, your kids are going to be
happy.
Your kids are going to be open. Your kids are going to be different. They're going to be free, because they learn that from you. So the more you work on yourself, and the better you feel about yourself, the better mother you're going to be. And that's amazing, because you get to change the DNA in your kids and their kids to help them have the things that perhaps you didn't have growing up. And it all starts with you, but just you living that walk and you knowing that you're coming from that good place to be a wonderful mother, open and free. In a moment, not just yet, but in a moment, I'll count from 1 to 5. On the count of 5, that suggestion will be tattooed in your brain, making you an amazing mother, even better than you are now. Now you're a great mother. 1, becoming aware of the sounds around you other than the sound of my voice. 2, gently be able to shake your fingertips and toes, allow full circulation to return to your entire body. 3, take a nice big deep breath in of love, energy, light and transformation. And breathing out the crap you no longer want or need in your life. 4, just allowing full sensation to come back into your body. And when your unconscious mind has accepted this suggestion for your own benefit, you'll be able to open your eyes feeling amazing. Good job, you can move your foot now, family. Good job. Lovely to meet you.